Hey guys, welcome. Let's look at NIO. This stock has gained more popularity because of its tremendous performance. Look at the results. It's almost 20 times your money if you have invested in March 2020 and 100% returns if you would have bought it a month ago. Wow. So why is this stock doing pretty good? And at this share price, is it still a buy? I have an answer to these questions. Let's get into the video. Welcome to Let's Make Education Free channel. If you remember my last video, I said NIO has the potential to become a strong EV player. What is so special about NIO? NIO is a Chinese car company who wants to lead the way in manufacturing smart, electric and autonomous vehicles. Since it's a Chinese company, it has huge government support from the Chinese government. NIO was burning a lot of cash in order to grow its business and it needed financial support. Chinese government stepped in and invested a lot of money into NIO. Tencent is also a big investor in NIO, so this is a huge advantage for NIO. Tencent is one of the biggest companies in China with offerings like WeChat, Tencent QQ. So in my opinion, getting cash will not be a huge problem for NIO due to the government support and Tencent backing. NIO is special in the way it treats its customers. Customers are increasingly perceiving NIO as a high-quality premium brand with best-in-class technology and customer service. And NIO's average customer referral rate increased from 52% in 2019 to 62% in the first half of 2020. This clearly shows that customers are happy with the product and they refer NIO to their friends. This is a huge plus for any business. Next, let's look at NIO's battery as a service offering, known as BaaS. BaaS is a service where car owners can swap the battery instead of charging them. This allows them to reduce the cost of the car. Customers can subscribe to this BaaS service, so it gives them flexibility as well as cost savings. Any subscription-based business model is a great way to make money. This BaaS service is awesome because it can easily save around $10,000 for the customer when they buy the car. For example, let's have a look at Tesla. And let's say if you have a new battery technology in the future, you wouldn't be able to switch to the latest battery. However, with the BaaS service offered by NIO, you can easily switch to the latest battery. And as and when new technology comes in, you can easily upgrade. So this is a great selling point for NIO. In China, this battery swapping technology is becoming increasingly popular. Till now, they have done about 1 million swaps. NIO emphasizes the benefits of subscribing over buying and the cost savings consumers can achieve. BaaS is also chargeable, swappable and upgradable, which is attractive among Chinese consumers. Tesla tried doing this battery swapping thing many years ago, but many customers were not interested, probably due to Western consumers' differences in preferences. Since the customers did not show much interest, Tesla changed its strategy to what it has now. Another interesting thing is, Tesla is a vertically integrated company and it has worked out well for Tesla so far. NIO took an opposite approach and functions as a platform, which is another unique aspect about NIO. We saw how Tesla is more than just a car company, it's an energy company. Similarly, NIO is not just a car company, it is trying to provide an ecosystem just like Apple. It offers NIO House, NIO Power, NIO Life, etc. NIO House is pretty unique and offers things like bookable meeting rooms, shared workspace, library, cafe, where family and friends can meet and hang out. Only NIO customers can use the NIO House, and since it's so exclusive, a lot of NIO customers like it. So now, let's go to our next point. Let's talk about why NIO stock price has increased so much over the last few weeks. Firstly, JP Morgan analyst increased the price target for NIO. It made the stock more popular and more retail investors started buying into the stock. It's not just JP Morgan. There are other banks such as Citi, Deutsche Bank, etc. who have increased their price target for NIO, which all contributed to NIO's price increase. In October, NIO released its Q3 delivery report that met expectations. NIO sold 5,000 cars in 1 month. This was a record high delivery and NIO is gaining popularity. Another reason for NIO's popularity is its planning to sell cars in Europe next year. This is well received among investors, since people see it as a premium brand that has the potential to reach customers worldwide and not just be restricted to Chinese customers. So basically, to summarize, increase in analyst price target, increasing popularity, more institutions entering and buying into the stock has caused NIO's price to skyrocket in the recent few weeks. Is it still worth buying? For example, when I started buying NIO, it was about $22. When I was buying, I felt that it would reach $40 by next year, but now it has already reached $40, and in my opinion, it has reached its valuation. So right now, I'm not planning to buy more. In my opinion, all the stuff that NIO has done so far has been priced in. But if you are going to buy NIO for a long term, for 5 years, let's say, I expect it will reach $200. China wants to achieve 25% electric vehicle by 2025. This target shows us that China wants to reduce pollution and decrease its dependence on oil. So in 5 years, I do believe NIO will reach $200. If you are going to buy and hold for 5 years, then buying right now at $40 is still worth, since it would potentially reach $200. But if you want to buy for the short term, then I can't really recommend you to buy, since in my opinion, it has already reached its valuation. Only if NIO announces some unexpected news on November 17th, then the price might increase further. If you look at discounted cash flow method, the price comes to around $45. So it might increase by another $5 before November 17. But generally, when earnings are released, there will be a slight dip in price in big tech companies. And it happened with NIO as well. I'm not sure what is going to happen with NIO for Q3 earnings, and I'm eagerly waiting for the November 17th update. NIO might be able to beat analyst estimates, but since it has been increasing so much in the last few weeks, I think there will be a pullback. So if that is true, and if price dips, then I'll be happy to buy more NIO stocks. Once the Q3 earnings is out, I'll be doing an analysis on it. And if you'd like to learn more about NIO, please consider subscribing to this channel. And don't forget to join my Telegram chat for regular updates. We have talked about the company and its share price, but do remember, it is a high growth stock. Since this is a high growth stock, the company has risks. It is a Chinese company, so investors are worried about the possibility of delisting the stock from New York Stock Exchange. But since Biden has won the election, the trade war between the US and China has the potential to decrease. So delisting risk would also decrease slightly. But do remember that the risk is not completely gone. Another big risk is that the company is expected to be profitable only in 2023. So it's a highly speculative play. If China achieves 25% EVs by 2025, and if NIO manages to get a big stake in the 25%, then all will go well. The beauty about this stock is its risk and reward ratio. If you look at 2019, China sold close to 27 million cars. In 27 million, 25% is about 6 million cars, and they want the 6 million to be EVs by 2025. So in my opinion, NIO has the potential to be a huge part of the 6 million cars, so I'm going long in this company. Of course, NIO also has a lot of competitors like Tesla, Zeeping, Li Auto. In fact, Elon Musk tweeted last week that $420 is 10 times greater than $42. In this tweet, Musk is clearly talking about NIO. In the last 6 years, what NIO has done is in fact much more than what Tesla has done. Chinese EV market is a huge market for any automobile player, so we can already see that Musk is starting to feel the competition from NIO. Everyone knows going into China market as a foreign player and sustaining the business is very difficult. NIO has a huge advantage since it is a Chinese company with strong government support. So even if Tesla has technologically strong products, to win in the China market, technologically sound products alone are not sufficient. Competition is heating up, and as consumers, this is great news for us. Tesla will innovate even further, bring costs down, and NIO will also keep innovating. So it's win-win for us. NIO CEO Li Bin also seems to be a nice guy. Last week, he launched the 100 kilowatt hour battery, and in that event, Bin was talking about how we should all transition towards sustainable energy. It seems like Li Bin wasn't solely looking at Tesla as a direct competitor, but rather as a co-player who can bring about the change together. Product-wise, they are not exact competitors because NIO is currently only producing premium cars, but in the future, NIO might launch more direct competing products to Tesla. In today's situation, EVs to EVs are not really big competitors to each other. Today, the real competition is between internal combustion engine and electric vehicles, and the electric vehicle is clearly going to win. Each EV manufacturer has their own pros and cons. I personally like NIO. Of course, you guys already know that I'm a big fan of Tesla. After Tesla, the next company I like is NIO. Great, this is my analysis and use it for your education. As usual, you do your analysis and if you believe there is a huge upside for NIO, then consider investing in NIO. As always, go for the long term. Let me know your thoughts about this video in the comment section and do me a favor by clicking the like button. It's encouraging. This is a decade for EVs, so having NIO in your portfolio is a good thing in my opinion. Together, let's become rich and let's make education free.